courses I teach in both the fall and spring. It involves collaboration with other universities. In the fall, I teach a class that has students from NC State. And in the spring, I teach a class that is jointly in a collaboration with another class over at Duke. In thinking about my use of Sakai, I've found it very easy to transition from Blackboard. I think it's been very intuitive. Students have had no issues with the transition. And I've found overall, in anything I'm trying to do with the Sakai system, that it's fewer mouse clicks than it was in Blackboard. It's been really easy to get students from other schools into Sakai because I can do it myself. I don't need to issue a help ticket. I can just go to the appropriate spot in Sakai and enter their names and email addresses, and presto, they're in the system. I'm using a number of tools that help with collaboration across greater distances. One of the big things that I'm doing is using the wiki. So it allows students from either institution to post information that everybody can see. In one of my classes where they have weekly programming and hardware development assignments, they post some troubleshooting tips on there, and then everybody can see that information, and it allows students across a greater distance even to share information of issues they encountered while working on their assignments. Sakai makes it really easy to integrate a Google Calendar with the Sakai website. And since I use Google Calendar for all my other calendar purposes, I can post calendar information about the course straight to my Google Calendar. It automatically is reflected on the Sakai website so students can see that. And they can even download or link their own personal calendars to the Google Calendar that way as well. In all the classes I teach, it involves group projects. So I do use the group tool to allow students to share information within their group and allow me to share information with particular groups. So the group tool has been really nice for a lot of respects. Once you set up the groups, you can send out emails directly to any individual group that you can select. You can also create group folders so they can post documents that are only seen by their group, and I can post documents that are only seen by a particular group. So it makes it really easy to do this group interaction. Another thing that I really liked about Sakai is that the resources folder, which is where you can post different documents that you want all the students to see, that you have the ability to set that up through the WebDAV protocol and access that outside of Sakai itself using an FTP program or a mapped drive. Through a program like CyberDuck or another FTP program, you can set up a folder structure. You can easily download and upload and delete and move around files so that it's in the exact format that you'd like, and it's much easier to get it well organized for the students so that they can more easily find the information that you're putting out there.